What's up, everybody? We're back at it again on r/entitledparents, and I got 5 crazy stories to share with you today, so let's just jump into it. Our first story comes from user Legal to Overcook. I have an older brother, and we have a great relationship. He's married, but I never felt comfortable around his spouse. But since it's not my business, I never said anything, especially since my brother seemed happy with his choice. 2 weeks ago was my niece's 5th anniversary. They decided to throw a big party, and I was invited. I asked my brother what to bring his kid, since I'm not good at all these things, but he said that any toy should do. A few days after this conversation, his wife called me and said that her kid needed an iPad, and that it would be great if her uncle would bring her one. You smell that, everybody? I smell a scam. I'm starting to think that the mom doesn't want to spend money on the iPad for the kid, or maybe she wants to get a free iPad out of her kid's 5th birthday. But hey, that's just speculation. We haven't finished the story yet, so maybe things will unfold differently. It amazed me. So I called my brother and asked him again, but he said the same thing. Bring some toy and forget about it. I consulted my friend who has 2 kids, and she told me that a mud kitchen for kids would be great for his age, arguing that it's an excellent way to teach a kid new skills, so I simply ordered one and wrapped it festively. When opening the gifts, mine was last. My niece had a tantrum when she saw it wasn't a tablet. She started screaming at her mom, "You said that uncle would give me a tablet! You promised me!" It was an ugly scene, and they barely calmed her down. Everyone just stared at me, and I felt very uncomfortable. While my brother was saying goodbye to the guests, his wife approached me and started scolding me for letting them all down and making her look bad. She apparently expected that I'd apologize, and since I didn't, she got outraged. She started yelling that until I learned to respect her and buy the iPad, I'm not a wanted guest in her house. So I simply left. The weirdest thing is that my brother doesn't answer my calls. To be honest, I don't know what to think. Is this my fault? What a common story. What a common story. You were supposed to pick up that iPad, man. That was not a suggestion. That was not an ask. That was a thinly veiled demand that you didn't fulfill. And congratulations, now you can't see your niece. And to be honest, I wish that was the worst thing about the story. Not only did OP do nothing wrong, but his brother refuses to call or apologize for what happened. Matter of fact, it seems like the brother's outright just ignoring this dude, hoping that everything would just blow over. That behavior, in my opinion, is way worse than the mom. If I was in this guy's shoes, I would immediately stop talking to my brother, completely cut connections, don't arrive at any events, because you didn't have my back. You just let me take the L so that you could preserve your relationship with your wife. It's genuinely pathetic. And I really hope that this guy doesn't put up with that stuff, man. Don't reach out, don't try to repair things, move on, because it already seems like your brother has. Our second story comes from user Grimace for Eyes. Yesterday, I, 37 female, got off the plane in the US and rushed to the airport bathroom. I have radiation colitis from cancer treatment, and I'm prone to diarrhea / incontinence. I had a small accident while deplaning, but I was trying to hold the rest in until I got to the bathroom. Unfortunately, this is not the first time this has happened, and I carry clean clothes and wipes with me whenever I travel. Anyway, I noticed a long line in the women's bathroom, and I saw that the family care bathroom was vacant. And bonus, nobody was around looking to use it. So I stepped inside. I hear someone screaming behind me, but I ignore it because it's a busy airport and I thought nothing of it. As I'm closing the door behind me, a woman carrying a baby literally puts her hand / body between the door and opens the door, and the following interaction occurs. "Excuse me, this is a family restroom. This is not for you." Me trying my best to hold in the rest of my shit. "Sorry, you'll have to wait. We need to use this bathroom." "Okay, not that this is any of your business, but I have a disability." "What disability?" She's still preventing me from closing the door with her body / hands while holding a baby, mind you, and literally would not let go, still screaming, "What disability?" She still held on. I overpowered her and pushed her back with the door, then pulled the door closed and locked it. Her and her baby. You don't have a monopoly on family restrooms, which need a completely different title altogether, in my opinion, and you don't have to harass a literal cancer patient because you chose to reproduce. I hope she and her baby shit their pants like I did. That is a crazy way to end a post, oh my god. But it was completely warranted and deserved. This mother was almost certainly lying about how much she needed to use the bathroom, because she was willing to not only hold the door, but shove her body through a door to keep it open, all while arguing with someone with an unknown disability. You didn't need to pee that bad, because you were willing to talk, you were willing to scream in this woman's face. So what I think is true is that maybe the bathroom that OP went to was the bathroom closest to the gate. That's it. it, just convenience. She was willing to lambast a woman for convenience. But that might not be true. That's just pure speculation. But I'm happy to say that we don't have to speculate who's crappy in this situation, and it's certainly not the person who is suffering with literal cancer and needs to use the closest bathroom to the gate in order to not shit her pants. Our third story comes from user Outside the Walls. Every year, I host a neighborhood party for the 4th of July. Everyone is welcome, unless they decide to be an asshole. I live in a pretty poor area, and I'm the only one with a pool, and I bought the property next door and knocked the house down, so I have a double-sized plot. I'm not saying any of this to brag, just explaining the background information. Plenty of room to party. The party went well. People started showing up around 1 p.m., we played pool, we chased my dogs around the yard, we ate some barbecue, and we had some beers. The teenagers went to take a walk, read smoke pot, right before sunset, so it was just adults and small children around when I started my fireworks show. Every year, I spend $2,000 to $3,000 on fireworks. I only set them off between 9 p.m. and 11 p.m. on the 4th, and I'm not one of those folks setting off fireworks for a week before or after the holiday. One rule I have is that I am the only person who is allowed to light fireworks on my land. If anyone is getting rushed to the ER, missing some fingers, it's not gonna be one of my guests, it's gonna be me. So, I set off my first three rounds of mortars, 28 total fireworks, and as I'm getting set up for the fourth round, 22 fireworks, a woman who I have never met approaches me. She's apparently my fourth neighbor to the west sister, but I had no idea who she was at the time. My daughter is really enjoying the show, but she wants to light one instead of just watching. Sorry, I don't let anyone light my fireworks on my property but me. This isn't exactly safe, and more importantly, I don't want to get sued. Oh sugar, she's okay, she'll be fine, look how sad she is. At this moment, she points at a smiling girl who is clearly no older than 7. I'm sorry, but even if she were 21, I wouldn't let her do it. There's no way I'm letting a child risk their fingers. You just want to hog all the fun for yourself. You've set enough of them off. Time for LaDondre to have a turn. Stop being selfish. Ma'am, you and your daughter have been enjoying my food, my pool, and my yard for the past 8 hours for free! And you're telling me I'm selfish because I care about your child's safety? But she wants to light one. That's not going to happen. And if you continue to push the issue, I'm gonna have to ask you to leave. Now kindly step back so I can continue the show. We've been arguing this whole time and people wanna see fireworks, not arguments. Just sit back and enjoy the holiday. At that point, she went over to her daughter, grabbed her by the arm, and went back to her brother's house. I feel bad for the kid. She missed the rest of the show and she missed the homemade ice cream cake that I brought out at the end of the party. Her brother and kid stayed at the party and had a great time. I hope the little girl was at least able to watch the show from the window from her own yard or something. LaDondre? LaDondre, seriously, you named your child that? LaDon is already a real name. You could have just stopped there. Your mind was in the right place. You already won the game. But I digress. That's hardly the issue here. The issue here is this mom's thinly veiled attempt to take attention away from the fireworks show and give it to her child. I'm pretty sure the kid didn't care that much. It was absolutely just an attempt by the mom to be the center of attention at this very popular event. And unfortunately, she didn't get what she wanted, so the kid couldn't get to see the rest of the show. And that's how I know it wasn't about the kid. If it was all about this little girl having a good time, then why remove her from the situation? Why not let her see the rest of the fireworks? It's just so funny to me that she really tried to use her daughter in order to become the center of attention, man. It's so pathetic. Our fourth story comes from user Leto Win. I read another story recently that reminded me of this incident, which took place in the early aughts. I was working at a large church, 2,000 plus members, and on Sundays, I ran the audio and video booth. We had three services, 7 a.m. early service, main service at 10 a.m., and late service at 11:30 a.m. Each service ran about an hour and 15 minutes. One Sunday during 10 a.m. service, the pastor's wife went into labor 3 weeks early. The pastor left in the middle of his sermon and the youth pastor took over. The youth pastor did a great job of taking over and wishing the mother and baby well, and that service wrapped up early. We had a quick meeting to decide what to do about the 11:30 service, and the youth pastor volunteered to give a sermon that he had pre-written for a youth group later in the week. It was his first time giving a sermon in front of that many people up on a big stage. He was nervous and rolled through it quickly, then forgot about the closing song, so the church ended at 12:15 instead of the normal 12:45. Everyone had cleared out of the church by 12:30-ish. I shut down all of the equipment and turned out the lights and went down the hall to make sure the lights were out in all of the classrooms, like I normally did. One light was on, and I found Kay, another church employee who worked in the nursery on Sundays. She was sitting in a rocking chair, rocking a toddler, and I saw tears rolling down Kay's face. I asked her what was wrong, and she could hardly speak. She was so upset. She said the toddler's parents had dropped him off before early service and never came back. The poor baby had been there for almost 5 hours. The parents had not given a contact number. All Kay knew was the child's first name. I immediately called the youth pastor, who quickly turned around and came back to the church. The child was very out of sorts, either hungry or tired. We had snacks, but no food, and there really wasn't a place to put a kid down for a nap. I ran to get some chicken nuggets while they figured out what to do. When I got back, a couple had pulled right in front of me, and they asked where everyone was, and I said church ended early. They said, okay, we're just here to pick up our son. I wasn't about to get involved with the drama, so I just unlocked the door and let them in. The youth pastor was livid and lit into them. It turns out the parents wanted some alone time and had been dropping their kid off at church and then leaving to go do stuff. They had been doing this for weeks, just dropping him off around 7:45 a.m. and coming to pick him up around 12:45 p.m. Here's the part where the parents are really entitled. They got mad at the youth pastor for ending church early. They yelled at him for endangering a child and threatened to sue. The dad was up in the youth pastor's face, and I thought they might fight, but the youth pastor was a big dude, and I think that kept the dad from doing anything else. I didn't stay in there. I went to the next room with Kay and the child and gave him the nuggets, which he gulped down. The parents finally took the kid and left. The youth pastor and his wife took us to lunch because we, mostly Kay, were still upset by the whole thing. I think about that kid a lot. I hope his parents didn't abandon him. I wish I had a follow-up, but as far as I know, they never came back. Police! Law enforcement! Jail time! Seriously, somebody should have called the cops. Somebody should have said something about child neglect, because that is really abnormal and terrible. Even if it was for one day, these parents abandoned a child once a week for 5 hours with people that they don't know just because they wanted to have some free time? You don't get to have free time if you're a parent, bro. I mean, sure, you can make free time happen, but in general, if you're a parent, you're a parent, and you kind of have to abandon that selfishness. I mean, what's the cliche? Everybody in their 50s waiting for their kids to move out and go to college so they can finally have some alone time. But unfortunately, in this story, this kid has scumbag parents who value their own time over this kid's safety and well-being. And yeah, I gotta admit, it is kind of scary not knowing what happened to this kid and whether or not he actually received a childhood. This story happened 23 years ago, but I couldn't imagine spending 18 of those years with parents that don't love you. Our final post comes from user Veggie Vengeance. I posted this in another forum, but received a lot of comments telling me to post it here as well. I, 26 female, live in a rented house with a single mother, 30 female, and her son, 6. I had another person living with me, but they moved out and the mother moved in. I don't mind living with her and her kid. It's fine and we kind of do our own thing. I spend a lot of time at my boyfriend's place or working and our work schedules collide, so we really don't interact much, but when we do, it's fine. No issue there. I want to start with saying that she clearly struggles financially, but I don't think it's an excuse. And look, I don't make a lot of money either. However, I've noticed that my food would go missing or portions would be taken from it. I assumed it was her kid, so I asked her if she'd stop him from eating my food. I was calm about it, and she just said she would. It really didn't upset me when it first started. It started getting annoying when I'd get home from work and expect to have a meal's worth of leftovers in the fridge, only to see it picked through or just gone. I kept bringing it up, and she started getting annoyed with me bringing it up. I began observing them, and I realized that neither of them ever ate vegetables. And by judging the food that would get picked through and the food that would be untouched, anything with green in it was avoided. Orange chicken would be gone, but the chicken and broccoli would be untouched. So I started putting vegetables in everything. I find vegetables to be delicious, and everything green or not a potato does not get eaten. So I mixed some bell peppers into the food, and it would be fine. I make a big portion of vegetables, pretty frequently anyway, so I just started putting it in everything I eat. I even had leftover mashed potatoes, and I pour green beans and mix it up. I had leftover cheesy bacon fries, and I pour broccoli all over it and mix it in. Usually my homemade stuff has vegetables in it, but I started making sure everything did. I made a pot of mac and cheese, the kid's favorite thing, and poured in roasted Brussels sprouts, which is actually delicious to me, and I'm eating more vegetables, so it's a win-win. She had been seeming annoyed, but we were all at home when I made the pot of mac and cheese. She was in the living room and saw me get out the Brussels sprouts and was like, "What are you gonna do with that?" And I poured them in. She said I was being greedy and annoying, and I just said I like Brussels sprouts, and that was it. She said, "We need food," and I told her, "Go get some, or stop buying only prepackaged things and your money would go further." I think she sees this as some big act of revenge, but I just simply want to be able to eat my food. Also, I want to add that sharing is not the issue. It's expecting to have food there, and it's not. So often, I'd be working a long day and get home expecting to have a meal's worth of food, and it'll all be gone. Or I wake up in a rush and had food ready to eat in the morning, only to find it gone. So now I have to skip breakfast. If she would simply text sometimes, hey, is it okay if we eat food item? I would know and know to make other plans. I would stop for food or know that I'd have to whip up something when I get home. Also, I think eating the last of someone else's food is crazy and rude. If someone makes a big pot of something and you ask for a serving, sure. But if someone made something and there's only one serving left and you eat it without permission, that is evil as hell. I do not play with that at all, bro. It's one thing to use other people's pots and pans and maybe plates if you're moving in with someone or sharing a space with someone, but I would never eat somebody's food, let alone their last portion. If I was in this woman's shoes, I would be even more petty. Not only would I change the way that I eat the same way that she did in order to discourage someone from eating my food, but I'd also go out of my way to purchase a small little mini fridge or micro fridge and have a padlock on it for all of my better food, all of my snacks, all of my larger portions, just so that in the case that this child develops a taste for mac and cheese and Brussels sprouts, I won't be without. It's so crazy that she tried to guilt trip you by saying that, oh, I'm broke and my child is hungry. And I'm glad you checked her, because a lot of people try, man. A lot of people try to justify stealing because they don't have cash. It's trashy behavior to take from others, especially if you're stealing food from somebody who shares a space with you. How can you live with yourself? I know I certainly couldn't. I would feel like the biggest gremlin on the planet. Especially because I would have a child in that situation. Imagine not being able to feed your own kid. It's just absolutely insane, just terrible behavior. But what do you guys think? I want to know what you guys think about every single story that you've heard today. Go ahead and let me know in the comments down below. And if you're curious about what game is playing in the background, it is City State 2. So if you're interested in playing the game, now you know what it is. It's a very good city sim game. I recommend it wholeheartedly. So yeah, that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and I'll catch you guys at the end. What's up, everybody? It's your boy Ailerus, aka Panda Daddy, and I hope you enjoyed today's video. And if you did, let me know in the comments down below and leave a like if you liked the video. And if you're new to my channel, go ahead and subscribe, fam. What you doing watching videos and not subscribing? And if you're old, make sure to hit that bell so you get these notifications every time. Go ahead and check out the community tab because there's another content poll for next week. So if you want to put in your 2 cents, if you want to have control over the future, go ahead and take a look at that poll and vote on the video that you want to see. And as always, I gotta thank the Patreon supporters that make content like this possible. A big thank you to MyZoom, Tristan, Damspool, Tori, Sleepy Dragon, Ducky Aiden Loves Ailerus, Dr. Mambo, Power Lover, Sherry Morrison, Tron Destroy 23, The Eggs 1, Fitz Chivalry, Din Korda, Co Connor Purvis, Ailerus's Mom, S16, Squish, Rinhex, Rare Days, Mr. Bean, My Golden Experience, James Tucker, Big Boy Bailey, BMX30, Cinnamon Sticks, Scott, The Fake Musician, Buckethead, Samantha Bellhart, Admin Vaniker, Zach F, Bloody Hunter, Keely, Dundernass Hawk, Lady Laughs a Lot, Swiss Patreon user, and Noah. Thank you so much for your support. It is greatly appreciated. And if you want to help support the channel, there's 2 links in the description, one in my merch store and one in my Patreon. Both funds go directly into the channel so we can maintain what's happening here. And as always, stay zesty.